Mystic Bell is a Metroidvania adventure game starring a plucky young witch named Bell. While training, a mysterious stranger causes an accident while passing her. Now, the three elder witches of the school blame her for this catastrophe. In order to save herself from being expelled, Bell embarks on a quest to remake the potion that was lost. In typical Metroid fashion, you're stuck in one ever-expanding environment. You begin with the ability to shoot fireballs and jump. On your quest, you unlock new skills from bosses that'll help with traversal, like a lightning spell that can help awaken machinery or an air dash to reach new heights. Pretty standard, right? The one addition Mystic Bell adds to the mix is leveling up. Defeating enemies will net you experience. Once a new level is reached, your fire spell increases in power, and sometimes even changes the trajectory, like adding another ball to the mix. Your health also increases. It's not the first to do it, but the more RPG elements in my games, the better. But that's not the only twist, and this next one is a bit more problematic. True to my description, Mystic Bell is also an adventure game. New abilities are not the only thing getting your progress. NPCs are sprinkled into the environment, all with their own list of demands. Want past me? Then I want this. In order to get that, you need to trade for another item or find it. You've played this quest before. While no puzzle is terribly troubling, it made backtracking 10 times more hassling than a standard Metroidvania. These two genres should never have been mixed, or at least been better streamlined. So, not only do you have to remember places to visit once you get new abilities, you have to keep track of all the quests at hand for NPCs too. It made exploring a nauseating rendition of Telephone. This isn't the game's only problem though. While I love pixel art, and make no mistake, this is good work, it's just that Belle's large sprite is clunky, literally. She barely has enough strength to clear a single platform. Sometimes you have to hug the darn things just to sort of float above them. Even if the platforming controls were better, that larger sprite just wasn't aesthetically pleasing to me. It's like someone zoomed too far in to check something and forgot to zoom out before hitting print on the game. I know that's not how video games work, okay? So save that comment. You know what I mean. Stagnation is the curse that plagues the video game industry, so when a company comes up with a new idea like melding two genres together that haven't before, or rarely do, I applaud the effort. However, the implementation is messy here at best. Still, as much as I gripe, Metroidvanias are too compelling for me to avoid. It just took me a lot longer than seemingly necessary to complete this game because of all the backtracking. Mystic Bell! Stay for the Metroidvania, leave for the adventure. Did you know that was a reaction examiner video? If you liked it, you should subscribe to me to keep up with everything that I'm doing. Also, if you have some other interests, like sex for example, check out Tomops, which is a comedy sex podcast thing wherein my best friend and I check out the weird and abnormal and the erotic. And of course, you should support me on Patreon because, hey, I want to make the channel better and I want your help to do so. Plus, if you want to check out my writing, check out Game Jerk, where I have archives and new stuff for all projects, okay? You can find all the stuff and more in the description with the links below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all next time.